Pharaohs.
Hi.
Good afternoon to one and all. This is S. Shivaratan from TTWRS Boys Balanagar. So friends, today I want to teach an interesting subject to you. Before going to our subject, my friends can interact with you.
Hi, my name is A. Shiva. I'm studying A standard.
Hi, Sveros. My name is R. Madhu. I'm studying A standard.
Hi, Sveros. I'm K. Tarun. I'm studying A standard.
Hi, Sveros. My name is E. Hari. I'm studying A standard.
Okay, friends. We know that every student has their favorite subject. Can you tell what is your favorite subject?
Can I say Sphero?
You can, Sphero.
My favorite subject is physics.
My favorite subject is English.
My favorite subject is social studies.
My favorite subject is biology.
My too. My favorite subject is biology. Friends, anybody knows that? What is the definition of biology?
Shall I say Sphero?
You can, Sphero.
Biology is interesting subject which can deals with living organisms in our planet.
Yes, exactly right answer. Biology is an interesting subject which deals about the living organisms which are living on our earth. So, the word biology is derived from two Greek words. Those are bio and logos. In Greek language, bios means living things. Logos means study of. So, the study of living things is known as biology. Okay, friends?
Okay. Friends,
do you like stories?
Yes.
Which type of stories do you like?
Shall I say Sparrow?
You can, Sparrow.
I like comedy stories.
I like historical stories.
I like moral stories.
I like Panchatantra stories.
So you have your own favorite stories?
Yes.
Friends, now I want to tell a short story which is about our Mother Earth. Okay, friends?
Okay.
So the beautiful Earth is created by God. He also created small creatures like plants, animals, insects, birds, etc. Then later the goddess thought that who can take care of those creatures? And he also created human being on earth. And he warned to human, if you destroy the earth, it can lose all its beauty. Then the human is thanked to God and came on earth. Day by day, the human forgot what the goddess told and started cutting down trees and he did deforestation. By this, the earth lost all its beauty and became as desert. Then the human being prayed to God. The goddess appeared. Oh God, please forgive to me, he told to God. Then the goddess forgiven to human. By that reason, our earth left some greenery on it. Friends, how is this story?
Very nice.
Anybody knows that? What is the moral of this story?
May I swear?
You can, Sphero.
The moral of story is, we need to protect our Mother Earth.
Yes, exactly right answer. The moral of the story is, we need to conserve our Mother Earth.
Sphero, with your permission, shall I ask one doubt?
Why not, Sphero? Carry on.
What is the meaning of conservation?
Wow, what a fantastic question, friend. What is the meaning of conservation? The meaning of conservation is protection. Friends, observe the slide. What do you observe in that slide?
Can I, Sphero?
You can, Sphero.
Yes, in this slide we are observing different types of living things like human beings, plants, animals, etc. These types of living things are live on our earth.
Yes, exactly right answer. In that slide, we are observing that different types of living organisms like plants, animals, insects, birds, human beings, etc. So, these types of different types of living organisms are lived on our earth. Friends, will you guess that which topic I am going to teach?
Shall we discuss, Sphero?
You can, Sphero.
That is
biodiversity.
Wow, what a genius mind, friend. Exactly right answer. That is biodiversity and its conservation. Okay, friends?
Okay. Yes, Sphero.
Friends, today we are discussing about biodiversity and its conservation. So, the topic which are discussing today are definition of biodiversity, importance of biodiversity, losses of biodiversity, conservation of biodiversity, concept and conclusion, and lastly, nature friend. These are the topics which are today going to discuss. Friends, anybody knows that what is the definition of biology?
Shall I tell, Sphero?
You can, Sphero.
The varieties and variabilities seen in plants and animals is known as biodiversity.
Wow, what a fantastic answer, friend. The varieties and variabilities seen in plants and animals is known as biodiversity. Friends, can you give example of varieties and variabilities?
Shall I say, Sphero?
You can, Sphero.
The example of varieties and variability are plants and animals. Plants like Nepenthes, etc. And animals like tiger, etc.
Wow, what a fantastic answer, friend. Example of varieties and variabilities are plants and animals. Friends, anybody knows that what are the meaning of varieties and variabilities?
Shall I say, Sphero?
You can, Sphero.
Varieties means different, variables means changes.
Exactly right answer. Varieties means different, variabilities means changes. So, these are the meaning of varieties and variabilities. Friends, observe the slide. What do you observe in that slide?
May I, Sphero?
You can, Sphero.
In the slide, we are observing those are horse and dog. They belong to two species.
Yes, exactly right answer. In that slide, we are observing that those are dog and horse. They belong to two species. Friends, how do you tell us those are dog and horse?
Shall I say, Sphero?
You can, Sphero.
In this picture, we have observed dog and horse. They are different in color, height, weight, structure, etc.
Yes, exactly right answer. In this picture, they are dog and horse. They belong to two species. They are different in color, shape, size, structure, etc. Friends, observe the another slide. What do you observe in that slide?
Shall I tell, Sphero?
You can, Sphero.
They all are human beings. They all are belong to only one species. They are different in structure, shape, height, color, etc.
Exactly right answer. In this slide, we are observing that those are human beings. They belong to only one species. So they are different in color, shape, size, structure, etc. Friends, here we want to conclude that by observing these two pictures, in first picture, we are observed there are two species. So in those two species, we find different in color, shape, size, structure, etc. And in second picture, we find it there is only one species. In that one species, we find different in color, shape, size, structure, etc. So these differences are occur in biodiversity. Friends, observe the slide. What do you observe in that slide?
May I, Sphero?
You can, Sphero.
In this first picture, we are observing forest ecosystem. In forest ecosystem, we find number of trees and animals. Trees like banyan, bamboo, neem, etc. Animals like tiger, lion, fox, etc.
Exactly right answer. In that first picture, we are observing that it is forest ecosystem. In forest ecosystem, we find huge number of trees and many number of plants and animals. Trees like banyan trees, neem trees, bamboo trees, etc. Animals like chimpanzees, lions, deer, etc. Friends, in second picture, we are finding that it is aquatic ecosystem. So, what do you mean by aquatic ecosystem?
Can I, Sphero?
You can, Sphero.
Yes, it is aquatic ecosystem. In aquatic ecosystem, we find living things in water. Examples, hydrilla, lotus, water lily, frogs, fish, snakes, crocodiles, etc.
Exactly right answer. In second picture, we are observing that it is aquatic ecosystem. In aquatic ecosystem, the living organisms are lived in only water. The living things like lotus, snails, lions, etc. Friends, in third picture, we are finding that is it desert ecosystem. What do you mean by desert ecosystem?
Shall I tell, Sphero?
You can, Sphero.
Yes, it is desert ecosystem. In desert ecosystem, we can find little number of living things. Animals like desert snake and camel. And plants like cactus and aloe vera, etc.
Exactly right answer. in that picture, we are finding that it is desert ecosystem. In desert ecosystem, we find less amount of plants than animals. Plants like Nepenthes, Cycas, etc. And animals like camel, eagle, desert rat, desert snakes, etc. Friends, by observing these three pictures, what do you conclude?
Shall I say sparrow?
You can sparrow.
I observed different kinds of animals are there in different ecosystems.
Exactly right answer. In different ecosystems, they live different types of living organisms. So this is mean by biodiversity. Okay, friends?
Okay,
yes, sparrow.
Friends, observe the slide. What do you observe in that slide?
May I sparrow?
You can sparrow.
In the slide, we are observing first picture is butterfly, second picture is honeybee.
Exactly right answer. In that slide, we are observing that first picture is butterfly. In second picture, it is honeybee. Friend, what those are doing?
Shall I tell sparrow?
You can sparrow.
In the first picture, the butterfly is sucking nectar from flower. And also in second picture, the honeybee is sucking nectar from flower.
Yes, exactly right answer. In first picture, the butterfly is sucking nectar from flower. And in second picture, the honeybee also sucking nectar from flower. So friends, what are the uses to the plants by these insects?
Can I sparrow?
You can sparrow.
Yes, the uses of flowers is the flowers get pollination from honeybees and butterflies.
Exactly right answer. The flowers can get pollination by those honeybees and butterflies. Friends, what are the uses of pollination?
May I sparrow?
You can sparrow.
The uses of pollination is to form fruits, seeds, grains, etc.
Exactly right answer. The uses of pollination is to form seeds, fruits, grains, etc. Friends, if these insects are extinct, what problem is caused by the people?
Shall I tell sparrow?
You can sparrow.
Seeds formation, fruits formation and grains formation is not occur. We does not get sufficient food products. Ultimately, people can suffer with food scarcity.
Exactly right answer. Fruits formation, seeds formation and grain formation is not occur. Ultimately, the people can suffer from food scarcity. Friends, what are the main reasons for decreasing of these insects?
Shall I say sparrow?
You can sparrow.
Because of the farmers are using pesticides and spraying on the plant, so they are reducing day by day.
Exactly right answer. The farmers are spraying pesticides and fertilizers on the plants. When these insects are flying on the plant, they are losing their life. So this is the main causes for decreasing of these insects. Friends, what precaution does we want to take to conserve those insects?
Can I sparrow?
You can sparrow.
We should not use artificial chemical pesticides and fertilizers. We need to use natural methods to save those types of insects.
Exactly right answer. We should not use chemical pesticides and fertilizers. We must use natural pesticides and fertilizers which is obtained from nature. By these we can conserve those insects. Friends, what are the other causes for decreasing of these insects?
Shall I say sparrow?
You can sparrow.
That is deforestation.
Wow, what a excellent mind, friend. That is deforestation. Friends, anybody knows that? What is the meaning of deforestation?
Hey, sparrow.
You can sparrow.
Cutting down number of trees is known as deforestation.
Exactly right answer. Cutting down number of trees is known as deforestation. Friends, observe the slide. Removal of a forest or stand of trees where the land is there after converted to a non-forest use. Example of deforestation include conversion of forest land to farms, ranches or urban uses. Friends, what are the other causes for deforestation?
Shall I tell sparrow?
You can sparrow.
The main causes of deforestation are clearing the forest for the purpose of urbanization and for the purpose of agriculture.
Exactly right answer. Clearing the forest for agriculture purpose, for urbanization and for industrialization. These are the main causes for deforestation. Friends, now I want to explain you a small case study which is occurred in Ramagundam. Ramagundam is a small village which is in Karimnagar district. Once in Ramagundam, they have a dense forest In that forest, they live different types of wild animals like lion, tiger, chimpanzees, etc. Nearby the Ramagundam, there is one thermal power station. The main theme of thermal power station is to produce electricity from coal. By that reason, the urbanization is increased. The forest is cleared day by day. So many plants and animals are vanished from the forest. By that, so many animals are lost their habitat. This can cause that loss of biodiversity. Friends, how is the case study?
So sad.
Anybody knows that what is the main concept of this case study?
Shall I say, Sparrow?
You can, Sparrow.
The main concept of the case study is we should not do the deforestation. If we do deforestation, the plants and animals disappear from our earth.
Exactly right answer. The main concept of this case study is we should not do deforestation. If we can do deforestation, so many plants and animals are disappear from our earth. It can cause loss of biodiversity. Friends, observe these pictures. What do you observe in this picture?
Shall I say, Sparrow?
You can, Sparrow.
In this picture, we are observing panda.
Yes, exactly right answer. In this picture, we are observing it is panda. So, it is lady panda. Her name is Basi panda. It belongs to China. It is the oldest panda in the world. In the 1990, the first ASEAN game, it is the mascot of the ASEAN games. So, each and every peoples of Chinese allowed these panda. But by some climatic problems, this panda is dead on September 13 in 2017. So friends, panda is also going disappearing from our earth. So it can also causes that loss of biodiversity. We are not finding more pandas in our country and in our world. Friends, by the human activities, our biodiversity is losing very much. And so many animals are disappearing from our earth and they are losing their habituation.
With your permission, may I ask one question, Sparrow?
You can, Sparrow.
Which animal fall in danger?
Yes, what a good question. Which animals are falling in danger? So friends, observe the slide. What do you observe in that slide?
Me, Sparrow?
You can, Sparrow.
In the slide, we are observing white tiger, vulture and sparrow.
Yes, exactly right answer. In that slide, we are observing that they are white tiger, vulture and sparrow. So friends, these animals are in danger because of these animals are going to vanish from our earth. So these animals are called endangered species. The definition of endangered species is an endangered species is a species of animals, plants or other organisms that is in danger of becoming extinct. Friends, observe this picture. What do you observe in this picture?
Can I, Sparrow?
You can, Sparrow.
In this picture, we are observing that the birds are flying in the sky.
Exactly right answer. In this picture, we are observing that the birds are flying in the sky. So friends, why those birds are flying in the sky?
Shall I tell, Sparrow?
You can, Sparrow.
Maybe they are going to collect food.
Yes.
Maybe they are going to their nestlings.
Yes. Yes, friends, I told that, of course, right answers. But we know that some birds have their permanent nestlings. So they live throughout the year in same place. And other birds that does not have permanent nestlings. So they can join into small flocks and fly one place to another for food and shelter. Those birds are called migratory bird. Is it, friend?
Yes.
So now I want to explain a small example of migratory bird. Are you ready?
Yes.
In rainy season, so many migratory birds are migrate far away from other places. They are come to the Pulicott Lakes in our state. They can construct their nest on the trees nearby the villages. In the olden days, the people believe that those birds are divine. But today's days, so many trees are cutting down. By the season, the birds is very hard to construct their nest. So it can also cause loss of biodiversity. Friends, observe the slide. What do you observe in that slide?
Shall I say sparrow?
You can sparrow.
It is red data book.
Yes, exactly right answer. It is red data book. So friends, now I want to explain you about red data book. So WWF, World Wildlife Federation, is publisher this book. That is red data book. The another name of red data book is red list book. So in this book they contain that which animals are in danger, and it also gives that red signal to us. If it does not conserve those animals and birds, they are going to extinct from our earth. These and information are present in this red data book. Okay friends?
Okay.
Friends, observe the another slide. What do you observe in that slide?
Shall I say sparrow?
You can sparrow.
In this picture, we are observing kangaroos, kiwi, white tiger.
Exactly right answer. In that picture, we are observing that kangaroo, kiwi, and white tiger. So friends, these animals and bird is called as endemic species. So now I want to explain you about endemic species. The definition of endemic species means, endemic species means that are generally found in a particular area. So friends, kangaroo is endemic to Australia. Kiwi is endemic to New Zealand. White tiger is endemic to India. So friends, these animals are also falling in danger. They are also going to extinct from our earth.
Sparrow, with your permission, can I ask one doubt?
Why not? Carry on, sparrow.
What is mean by extinct?
Wow, what a good question. What is mean by extinct? Friends, observe the slide. What do you observe in that slide?
Can I sparrow?
You can sparrow.
That is dinosaur and dodo bird.
Exactly right answer. They are dinosaur and dodo bird. Friends, these bird and animals are seen in today's days?
No.
So these are vanished from our earth. So we call us these birds and animal as an extinct species. So the definition of extinct species means extinction in biology and dying out or termination of a species are dimensioned because of environmental forces. So the plants and animals which are vanished forever from our earth, those plants, animals and birds are called extinct species. So we does not find these animal and bird in today's days. They are extinct forever from our earth. Friends, now I want to keep you a small debate. Are you ready?
Yes.
This team is opposers and this team is supporters. Friends, your topic is deforestation.
Yes, deforestation is correct. By doing deforestation, we get timber from trees. Timber is most essential to prepare furniture.
I disagree with my opponent. Due to deforestation, the carbon dioxide gas is increasing in atmosphere, which causes global warming.
I support to my friend, because for constructing industries, houses, roads, etc., we need to clear forest land.
I disagree with my opponent's side, because so many living things which are living in the forest, they are losing their habitats.
I disagree with my friend saying, we prepare paper from some trees like bamboo. To produce more paper, we need to cut those types of trees.
I disagree with my opponent, because of due to deforestation, the temperature level is increasing, and also we should not get proper rains.
I support my friend, because for agriculture purpose, we need to cut number of trees.
I support my friend, because due to the deforestation, most of the birds and animals face food and water scarcity. That's why they are migrating to another place, and also they are attacking to human houses and agriculture fields.
I disagree which my opponent saying. If we suddenly reduce the deforestation, what is the position of our smart society?
I disagree with my opponent because of we know that the tribal peoples are living in forest. If we do the deforestation, then where the tribal peoples can live?
I support my friends. If do not do deforestation, where did we get class for ever increasing population?
I support my friend because due to the deforestation, what about our human activities and human intelligence?
By the deforestation, local peoples, particularly human, earning money by selling the firewood. Their livelihood is dependent on firewood.
I disagree with my opponent because of due to deforestation, the pollutions may increase in the atmosphere, which causes people can suffer with pollutions like air pollution, water pollution, land pollution, etc.
I disagree which my opponent saying. By the deforestation, we produce the needs of people. With a machine, it is equal to 100 people work.
I disagree with my opponent said. Yes, we know that technology is developing, but we are cutting timbers. Instead of them, we must want to use LPGs.
I support to my friend because of we know that forests are the lungs of our mother earth. If we increase the deforestation, then our mother earth lost its lungs.
Okay friends, okay, you did your good job. So now I want to support to B group, which is oppose the deforestation. We know that we have so many unuses by the deforestation. When we do deforestation, the global warming increase and rain scarcity increase. It is also ultimately, pollution is also increased. It is very harmful to our mother earth. So we should not do deforestation. If we do deforestation, so many plants and animals lost their habitations. Friends, what precaution do we want to take to conserve our biodiversity?
May I swear on?
You can swear on.
We should not do deforestation.
Yes. First point is we should not do deforestation.
Shall I tell Sparrow?
You can, Sparrow.
We need to plant more trees and start reforestation.
Yes. Second point is we need to plant more trees and start reforestation.
Shall I, Sparrow?
You can, Sparrow.
We should not do urbanization.
Yes. Fourth point is we should not do urbanization.
Can I, Sparrow?
You can, Sparrow.
We should not do more urbanization.
Yes. We should not do more urbanization. This is the fourth point. Friends, you are told that, of course, right answers. But our government has started some projects like Crocodile Project, Tiger Project. Our government of India is launched Tiger Project in the year of 1972. Our government has also started some schemes like national parks and sanctuaries to conserve plants, animals and birds.
With your permission, may I ask one question, Sparrow?
Carry on, Sparrow.
What is meant by national park?
Yes, what a good question. What is meant by national park? So friends, observe the slide. In that slide, we are observing that it is national park. The definition of national park is, a national park is a large area hitched to conserve the wildlife, particularly the wild animals, species in their natural habitat. For example, lions, tigers, rhinoceros, etc. No human activity is allowed in any form. Even grazing of domestic animal is prohibited. Example, Jim Corbett National Park of Uttarakhand. Friends, this is about national park. In national park, any human activity is not allowed.
Sparrow, with your permission, shall I ask one question?
Carry on, Sparrow.
What is meant by sanctuary?
Yes, very good question. What is meant by sanctuaries? So now I want to explain you about sanctuaries. Friends, observe the slide. What do you observe in that slide?
May I, Sparrow?
You can, Sparrow.
Those are birds in lake.
Yes, what a good answer, friend. Those are birds in lakes. So in this picture, we are also observing that sanctuary. So the definition of sanctuary is, a sanctuary is a place where conservation of species take place.
with an objective of allowing human activity in a limitation way without affecting the habitat. Example, Pakal Sanctuary, Warangal. So friends, in that sanctuaries, little amount of human activity is allowed.
With your permission, may I ask a question, sir?
Okay, why not? Carry on, sir.
What is different between sanctuaries and national park?
Wow, what a good question, friend. What are the differences between sanctuaries and national parks? So now I want to explain you about sanctuaries and national parks and the differences. So in national parks, any human activities like cutting down trees and hunting animals, even domesticating animals, is also prohibited in national park. Whether we compare to sanctuaries, in sanctuaries, little amount of human activities like deforestating the trees and hunting animals are allowed in little amount. These are the differences between sanctuaries and national parks. So the sanctuary is prepared as the forest land is collected by a government. Around the forest land, the fence is kept, and so many different types of species are collected from various places and they are released in sanctuaries. The main theme of sanctuary is to conserve the species of animals, especially birds. So little amount of human activities is allowed. In the national parks, the national park is constructed artificially. The trees are planted in the national parks. And in national parks, any human activities are not allowed. Even domesticating animals is also not allowed.
Sphero, with your permission, can I ask you a question?
Why not? Carry on, Sphero.
Can you give example for sanctuaries and national parks?
Yes, what a good question, friend. I can give example of sanctuaries and national parks. So the example of national parks are Jim Corbett National Park, Uttarakhand, Gir National Park, Gujarat. Example of sanctuaries are Pranahita Sanctuary, Khammam, Etu Nagaram Sanctuary, Jaishankar Bhupalpalli, Pakal Sanctuary in Warangal. These are the example of national parks and sanctuaries. Friends, do you understand our lesson?
Yes.
So now I want to put a small test for you. Are you ready?
Yes.
Now I want to conduct a small quiz to you. This is A group and this is B group. Fauna, this is flora. What is the meaning of fauna?
Animals.
Very good. The meaning of fauna is animals. What is the meaning of flora?
Plants.
Exactly right answer. The meaning of flora is plants. So first question goes to fauna. Extinction means
D, vanish forever.
Very good, friend. D, vanish forever. Question to B group, flora. Kangaroo is endemic to which country?
B, Australia.
Wow, very good, friend. B, Australia. Third question goes to fauna. Which of these help in pollination?
Birds.
A, insects.
Very good. A, insects. Last question goes to flora. Government of India is launched Tiger Project in which year?
1927 A.
Oh, sorry friend, you are confused. The correct answer is 1972. In this quiz, A group is winner, which is fauna. Friends, now I want to give gift to you. Do you imagine that which gift I am going to give you?
Can I Sphero?
You can Sphero.
Maybe I think rabbit.
No friend.
Can I Sphero?
You can Sphero.
Maybe I think pigeons.
No, sorry friend.
Can I Sphero?
You can Sphero.
Maybe dogs.
Sorry friend.
Phenoswera?
You can swear.
Maybe they are butterflies?
No, friend. You are told the wrong answers. So now I want to give special gift to you. This is for Flora.
Oh, it's very nice.
Very nice. So super.
Friends, this is the special gift for Fauna.
Oh, very nice.
Oh, friend. So, friends, you imagine that rabbits and butterflies, birds. So that is not good, because if I can give those gifts to you, it is very harmful to our biodiversity, because it is very loss to our biodiversity. Okay, friends?
Okay.
Okay.
Friends, what precaution do we want to take to conserve our biodiversity? You can swear.
We do not do more urbanization.
Yes, first point is, we do not do more urbanization.
Shall I tell swear?
You can swear.
We need to plant more trees and start reforestation.
Yes, second point is, we no need to do urbanization.
Shall I swear?
You can swear.
We cannot destroy animal habitats.
Very good. The third point is, we cannot destroy the habitat of animals.
Can I swear?
You can swear.
We should not use artificial chemical pesticides and fertilizers. We need to use natural methods.
Very good, friend. We do not use chemical pesticides and fertilizers. We use natural pesticides and fertilizers to conserve our biodiversity. Friends, to conserve our Mother Earth, we have to take nature pledge. Okay, friends?
Okay.
Get up. Stand up, friends. Stand up.
Observing the slide, friend. Nature pledge. Oh, my mother earth.
Oh, my mother earth.
I shall not misuse
the natural resources.
And pollute nature.
With pesticides.
And fertilizers. And plastic waste.
I shall
behave wisely
and strive for
the eradication
of superstition.
I promise to conserve
the biodiversity
and behave with aesthetic sense
to conserve our biodiversity.
Okay, friends, I cordially thankful to our beloved secretary R.S. Praveen Kumar sir and our institution principal Krishna Reddy sir, my mentor teacher Sri Lata madam, and my classmates and my staff. Especially, I am very thankful to T.SAT who supported me and success this program. Okay, bye, Sveros, and bye, friends.
Bye.